life inside world's largest aircraft carrier in middle of the ocean. Welcome back to U.S. Military on Spot Channel. As a military vessel, access to its interior is restricted and typically limited to authorized personnel such as crew members, contractors, and occasionally visiting dignitaries. The interior of an aircraft carrier like the USS George HW Bush would include various compartments and areas serving different purposes. Flight deck. This is where aircraft take off and land. It's a highly organized area with designated spots for different types of aircraft. The flight deck is a highly active and carefully orchestrated area where aircraft operations are conducted. The flight deck is organized into a grid of parking spots where aircraft are positioned when not in use. These spots are designated based on aircraft type and operational requirements. Hangar Bay, located below the flight deck. This area serves as a critical area for stores aircraft, maintenance equipment, supplies, and for flight operations. Bridge. The bridge of the USS George HW Bush is the nerve center of the ship, where the commanding officer and key personnel oversee and control its navigation, communications, and overall operations. Berthing areas. These are sleeping quarters for the crew, typically arranged in tight quarters. The berthing areas serve as living quarters for the ship's crew. These areas provide sleeping accommodations, personal storage space, and basic amenities for crew members during their off-duty hours. Mess halls. The mess halls, also known as dining facilities or galleys. This area serves as the primary spaces where the ship's crew members gather to eat their meals. These areas are crucial for maintaining the crew's nutrition and morale during long deployments at sea. Commanding officer's quarters. Living quarters for the ship's commanding officer. Provide living accommodations for the ship's commanding officer, typically a high-ranking naval officer with the rank of captain. Engineering spaces. These include the ship's propulsion systems, power generation, and other machinery necessary for operation. Encompass a variety of areas dedicated to the operation and maintenance of the ship's propulsion, power generation, and other critical systems. These spaces are essential for ensuring the ship's mobility, power supply, and overall functionality. Medical facilities, including a sick bay for medical treatment. Equipped with medical facilities to provide healthcare services for its crew members while at sea. These facilities are essential for addressing medical emergencies, providing routine health care, and supporting the overall well-being of the ship's personnel. Weapon systems. Areas where weapons are stored and operated, including missile launchers and defensive systems. Equipped with a variety of weapon systems to defend itself and to support its mission objectives. As an aircraft carrier, its primary offensive capabilities come from its embarked air wing, but it also has defensive and offensive capabilities on board. Training areas, spaces dedicated to training exercises and drills. Various training areas are essential for ensuring the readiness and proficiency of the ship's crew in carrying out their duties effectively. While space is limited on an aircraft carrier, there are dedicated areas and procedures in place to facilitate training activities. Providing recreational facilities is crucial for maintaining crew morale, promoting relaxation, and enhancing overall well-being during long deployments at sea. While space is limited on an aircraft carrier, there are designated areas and amenities dedicated to recreation. Communication Center. The Communication Center serves as a vital hub for managing and facilitating communication between the ship, other naval vessels, aircraft, shore facilities, and higher command authorities. Typically contains an operations room where personnel monitor and manage various communication systems and equipment. This room serves as the nerve center for communication activities onboard the ship. Storage areas. Storage areas are crucial for storing supplies, spare parts, equipment, and other materials necessary for the ship's operation, maintenance, and mission readiness. Given the limited space aboard an aircraft carrier, efficient utilization of storage areas is essential. Access to sensitive areas of the ship, such as the reactor room, is highly restricted due to safety and security concerns. Overall, the USS George HW Bush, like other aircraft carriers, is a self-contained city at sea, designed to support its crew and aircraft while projecting military power wherever it's needed around the globe.